looks good. Ciao Valentina. Ci sono molti colori che posso riutilizzare. Mi serve un pochino di blu di Prussia. Mi serve il turchese.
Person or an animal, you want to start with the eyes. So I'm going to put a little bit of aqua blue. You know, I'm going to put my glasses on. Excuse me, I'm going to reach over here and get my little glasses. How does that look? And come on back up here. You know, when you get old, you start to go a little blind. So I need to get some real fashionable glasses someday. So that's just aqua blue and white around the eye. Then I'm going to go into, I have a little bit of yellow. I'm not even going to wipe my brush out. Yellow and white. And their eyes are rather pale. They have pale color now, depending on what kind of macaw.
Mi serve per forza questo. Il mio stocchetto.
Coloration, but it's just very, very pale around the eyeball. I'm going to rinse. rinse off my brush. I use odorless thinner to rinse off my brush. Be sure your thinner is odorless because you don't want that really smelly, strong stuff. I'm going to dip into my white with just the tip of the brush, just the tip. Pick up a little white, and we're going to come up here to the eye, and we're going to hit just a little bit of highlight. Now, don't put it right in the center of the pupil, but just over to the side. Okay, I'm going to switch brushes, and I'm going to go into a little small flat brush, and I'm going to dip into some medium, and I'm going to get some white, and we're just going to fill this in. See the space area here? They have a very
Ah, ciao Melania, ma puoi scrivere?
They have lots of deep wrinkles in their face, and then they have little black kind of pin feathers. I guess that's what you call it, I don't know, on this face area. And again, the different macaws, I'm just dipping into more light, the different macaws have all different. designs on their face. Some don't even have this light, and we'll put a little up here. And then I'm going to rinse my brush off and go into our black and maybe a little white with that. I've got a little white mixed up with it. And let's get this little design going. These are the little pin feather-like. Just, I'm using the chiseled edge of the brush. This is so simple, it's ridiculous. Several years ago, I published a exotic bird book, and that was a great book. It's out of print now, but it was very, very popular, and I did all kinds of macaws in that book. And there's not very many people that paint the macaws, but people love them, and they're so much fun to paint. On this series, Gary and I are going to be painting a lot of birds, which we don't normally do. So I hope you get to watch every single show. And just using the edge of the brush, now you have to have good reference. And Gary's always talking about taking your photographs. I'm just dipping down now. I'm going to go into some sienna and gray that I've mixed up. Get a little warmer. Maybe I'll add a little more sienna. And we're going to put a little shadow up here. I'm going to wipe a little of that off my brush. There we go. And we want a little shadow in this area right here. And I'm just dipping down for some more of the same color. And a little bit right here. And we'll just shadow some areas in here where they have these deep wrinkles in their face. But photographing, you've got to have good reference for when you're painting. Because especially when you're doing birds or animals, this is black, I'm dipping into black. And he has kind of like a little nostril here. And then we'll take a blender brush and just soften some of that out a little bit. Very lightly hit it. And then we'll get some on his beak. Remember that was dry. This is gray, and I'm dipping into a little bit of the aqua also. And oh, by the way, I'm using ultra smooth canvas, which is great. It gives you so much more detail. See, I'm putting in, and this of course is oil paint that I'm using on top of the acrylic. I'm going to wipe my brush now. Maybe I'll rinse my brush off and soften. This is kind of a little reflected light. I don't know where it would be coming from, but it's just a slightly blue-gray. And if it's too strong, just dip into your black and soften it out. And then we'll go back into that light gray again. And division between his bottom beak and his top beak. And you can kind of see inside. This would be the inside of his mouth. And we'll make that a little lighter, kind of like a little light in there. And I'm going to soften that color out again. Again, it's not picking up any of the wet black because the black is dry, so I'm going to add a little black to just soften those lines a little bit. And he looks like a very, very happy little guy. A little gray and blue again. And just dab that on, wipe the brush. I normally paint wet on wet, and I don't put the acrylic on first, but again, that was just to save time for me because we have such a short amount of time up here. And then I'm going to dip into the red or red-orange, and this is just a color that I love to accent with, and that might be coming from some of the surrounding foliage or whatever, because their beaks are... shiny, so it would pick up light. Okay, we'll get on his little head up top there. We're going to start with some foliage green dark and some sienna, a little bit of sienna. I'm going to get very, very dark. Now, probably, maybe on camera, that might even look black to you, but at least on my monitor in the studio it does. But it's just a dark, dark green where the feathers come off of the forehead area and they start out, and then we've got a little dart shooting around in here. But Gary and I used to live in Florida many years ago, and we had so much fun photographing the birds all over, go to the nature parks and all over, and it was just so much fun. See how I'm kind of getting the feel of feathers already? Now this is green and yellow mixed together, and I'm going to tap, just tap, and leave texture in here. Tap, 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 because you want it to not be all smoothed out in here. You just want to blend it into your... because we have such a short amount of time up here. And then I'm going to dip into the red or red-orange, and this this is just a color that I love to accent with. And that might be coming from some of the surrounding foliage or whatever, because the beaks are shiny, so it would pick up light. Okay, we'll get on his little head up top there. We're going to start with some foliage green dark and some sienna, a little bit of sienna. I'm going to get very, very dark. Now, probably, maybe on camera, that might even look black to you, but at least on my monitor in the studio it does. But it's just a dark, dark green where the feathers come off of the forehead area and they start out. And then we've got a little dark shooting around in here. But Gary and I used to live in Florida many years ago, and we had so much fun photographing the birds all over. Go to the neighbor. To parks and all over, and it was just so much fun. See how I'm kind of getting the feel of feathers already? Now this is green and yellow mixed together, and I'm going to tap and leave texture in here. Tap, because you want it to not be all smoothed out in here. You just want to blend it into your shadow area just a little bit. Blend it in, and you can flip maybe a little feather out there. Don't get too flippy though with your feathers. And I'm going to soften it with a blender just a little. And then we're going to, I think we'll switch to a little bit bigger brush. And we'll start some blue on the feathers. Dip into a little medium. This is ultramarine blue with a touch of Prussian blue. And we're going to part some shadows, some shaded areas. They have layers of feathers. So where the layers, the forward layers come over, there's a little shadow area in here. So we want to get all the shadows established first. I think I'll take off my glasses. Maybe then I can see a little bit better. And we're going to get all these little darks in here, shooting around. There's some on the wing, down this area. And you always start with your darks and build up to your lighter layers. Now it's dark right behind the shoulder area here, because we have such a short amount of time up here. And we've got a little dark. And we had so much fun photographing the birds all over. Go to the nature parks and all over. And it was just so much fun. See how I'm kind of getting the feel of feathers already? Now this is green and yellow mixed together. And I'm going to tap and leave texture in here. Tap, because you want it to not be all smoothed out in here. You just want to blend it into your shadow area just a little bit. Blend it in. And you can flip maybe a little feather out there. Don't get too flippy though with your feathers. And I'm going to soften it with a blender just a little. And then we're going to, I think we'll switch to a little bit bigger brush. And we'll start some blue on the feathers. Dip deepened to a little medium. This is ultramarine blue with a touch of prussian blue. And we're going to part some shadows, some shaded areas. They have layers of feathers. So where the layers, the light, the forward layers come over, there's a little shadow area in here. So we want to get all the shadows established first. I think I'll take off my glasses. Maybe then I can see a little bit better. And we're going to get all these little darks in here, shooting around. There's some on the wing, down this area. And you always start with your darks and build up to your lighter layers. Now it's dark right behind the shoulder area here, maybe a little bit here. I'm using a lot of the chisel edge of the brush. Over here, there's some darks I see shooting out. And of course, the feathers all fall down the body. And there's a little bit in here. And maybe a little out here. Very loose, very sketchy. Oh, one thing I forgot. On the little black area, the little black feathers under his neck, there's just a little bit of light feathery area coming out here. Just very, very loose. You see that? And I'm going to bring the white down and just soften it. Bring some little feathers from his face. Start to get into this feather area. And wipe the brush. I always put paper. And we had so much fun photographing the birds. Area just a little bit. Blend it in. And we'll flip maybe a little feather out there. Don't get too flippy though with your feathers. And I'm going to soften.
Had a big cup.
under just a little. And then we're going to, I think we'll switch to a little bit bigger brush. And we'll start some blue on the feathers. Dip into a little medium. This is ultramarine blue with a touch of Prussian blue. And we're going to part some shadows, some shaded areas. They have layers of feathers. So where the layers, the light, the forward layers come over, there's a little shadow area in there. So we want to get all the shadows established first. I think I'll take off my glasses. Maybe then I can see a little bit better. And we're going to get all these little darks in here, shooting around. There's some on the wing, down this area. And you always start with your darks and build up to your lighter layers. Now it's dark right behind the shoulder area here, maybe a little bit here. I'm using a lot of the chisel edge of the brush. Over here there's some darks I see shooting out. And of course the feathers all fall down the body. And there's a little bit in here. And maybe a little out here. Very loose, very sketchy. Oh, one thing I forgot, on the little black area, the little black feathers under his neck, there's just a little bit of light feathery area coming out here. Very, very loose, you see that? And I'm going to bring the white down and just soften it, bring some little feathers from his face, start to get into this feather area, and wipe the brush. I always put paper towel in my brush, paper towel in my hand, so I can wipe my brush all the time. Let's soften this area right here. do, little delicate areas. So let's get a little more highlight on this area because they have start layering little feathers here. And we'll soften that out a little bit. The blender is great because you can soften and push areas back that are too bright. Now I'm going to go from the blue into the breast and neck area, and we'll start with a sienna and ochre mixed together, sienna and ochre, and we'll get some darks. Remember, we go into the darks first. But when I did my exotic bird book, I went around Florida and photographed all the reference material. And we used to go to the pier and photograph the pelicans and the big cockatoos, the white cockatoos. You might notice on the back of our wall of our studio, we have a lot of bird paintings. Gary and I do a lot of collaborations on the birds. Now this is just getting some shadow area going under the layers of feather. You see how loose and sketchy? Keep it very, very sketchy. Very, very loose. And it shouldn't look too neat and tidy right at this stage. And maybe a little dark over here. Put a little orange maybe with that sienna. A little bit of orange. All the macaws I love to do, but the blue and golds, I don't know, they're really one of my favorites. So we have hundreds and hundreds of photos at home, and a lot of you try to paint, I know some of you, and you don't have accurate reference. So it's really, really important that you get good reference material. So now I'm going to take a blender. Whoops, blender's got green on it. Maybe we better pick up a clean one. Of course, it wouldn't matter if there's a little green. And you see how I'm going to just smush this out? Is that a word, smush? That's my word. That's my artist's word. Smush this out and soften it. Soften this a little bit. Soften this area.
Sorry.
And I'm going to rinse. Marks first. A little more highlight on this area, because they have start layering little feathers here. And we'll soften that out a little bit. The blender is great because you can soften and push areas back that are too bright. Now I'm going to go from the blue into the breast and neck area, and we'll start with a sienna and ochre mixed together, sienna and ochre, and we'll get some darks. Remember, we go into the darks first. But when I did my exotic bird book, I went around Florida and photographed all the reference material. And we used to go to the pier and photograph the pelicans and the big cockatoos, the white cockatoos. You might notice on the back of our wall of our studio, we have a lot of bird paintings. Gary and I do a lot of collaborations on the birds. Now this is just getting some shadow area going under the layers of feather. You see how loose and sketchy? Keep it very, very sketchy. Very, very loose. I'm going to go from the blue into the breast and neck area, and we'll start with a sienna and ochre mixed together, sienna and ochre, and we'll get some darks. Remember, we go into the darks first. But when I did my exotic bird book, I went around Florida and photographed all the reference material. And we used to go to the pier and photograph the pelicans and the big cockatoos, the white cockatoos. You might notice on the back of our wall of our studio, we have a lot of bird paintings. Gary and I do a lot of collaborations on the birds. Now this is just getting some shadow area going under the layers of feather. Very, you see how loose and sketchy? Keep it very, very sketchy. Very, very loose. And it shouldn't look too neat and tidy right at this stage. And maybe a little dark over here. Put a little orange maybe with that sienna. A little bit of orange. All the macaws I love to do, but the blue and golds, I don't know, they're really one of my favorites. So we have hundreds and hundreds of photos at home, and a lot of you try to paint, I know some of you, and you don't have accurate reference. So it's really, really important that you get good reference material. So now I'm going to take a blender. Whoops, blender's got green on it. Maybe we better pick up a clean one. Of course, it wouldn't matter if there's a little green. And you see how I'm going to just smush this out? Is that a word, smush? That's my word. That's my artist's word. Smush this out and soften it. Soften this a little bit. Soften this area. And I'm going to rinse my brush off. And let's start in with those feathers on the wing. This is aqua blue, beautiful, like Caribbean blue water. I'm going to go from the blue reference material. So now I'm going to take a blender. Whoops, blender's got green on it. Maybe we better pick up a clean one. Of course, it wouldn't matter if there's a little green. And you see how I'm going to just smush this out. Is that a word, smush? That's my word. That's my artist's word. Smush this out and soften it. Soften this a little bit. Soften this area. And I'm going to rinse my brush off. And let's start in with those feathers on the wing. This is aqua blue, beautiful, like Caribbean blue water. And I'm using the side, see if you can see this, the side of the brush, the chiseled edge, and I'm pushing and lifting up, pushing and lifting up. Now the feathers are falling down this way, but I'm starting at the end of the feather and coming up toward the body. It's much the same way that you would do a daisy stroke almost. You push from the outside of the petal. And you could do this with a filbert brush. You could do this with the flat, which I'm using right now. And this is kind of the middle tone. It's not the lightest. I have a touch of white with it. Bring a little feather out maybe. And just let it fade off into nothing. Just let it fade off. Now I have a little bit of white down here, white oil paint on the bottom of my canvas, and that helps it just drift off. Now remember, this is the middle tone. You usually have a dark, a middle tone, and a light. But in between those two tones, you sometimes have other tones, like a and then a very bright light at the very end. So you don't just always have those three tones. And just a little bit here. Now this is the inside of his wing that's showing right here. This is where his body stops. This is the inside of the wing. And that's going to be, you're going to see yellow. And this is cad yellow medium. Cad yellow medium. And I'm going to mix a little bit of white with that. And I'm just going to loosely fill this in. Very loosely. And sometimes I use the chiseled edge and sometimes I use the flat edge. Now be careful you don't lose your darks. Now if you lose your darks, put a few more darks back in. Now again, this is just the middle tone. And we'll get a little bit on the inside of the wing. You're looking inside it. And we put the highlights on last. If you go in too soon on your highlights, then all you see is a bunch of bright highlights all around, and then the whole thing gets too busy. I'm going to go into a little bit of the darker mixed with the yellow down here because I want a little shading. I'm going to bring my white back up into this to soften this area and just what we call vignette it out. But try the parrots because they are so much fun. And easy. And don't try to paint along with us. Like I was saying on one of the shows, I love your enthusiasm when you all say, I try to paint with you, but you paint so fast. Well, yes, because we only have a few minutes up here. So don't worry about painting along with us. Just take your notes. You know, before I forget, I better get into the head up there, the head part here, and get some lights on there. We don't want to leave them with no color up here. This is just the aqua and the white. Don't get too many feathers coming out. Now, I'm going to take and rinse off my brush in the odorless thinner. And we'll get some white on the bottom. Anyway, I hope you all get to watch all our shows because we did a really wide variety, even though Gary and I specialize in flower painting. We did a really wide variety of things on this show. I think you'll really enjoy it. We love to paint all different subjects. But flowers and birds are probably my favorite. Gary likes birds and fish. I'm just vignetting this out on the bottom. Vignette is where the main subject, just goes out into the background, and it's usually just all white or very light around the edges. And it just fades into nothing. Okay, I'm going to rinse off a brush here and go into white. And light yellow. This is a very lemon yellow. And now the paint is put on dry. The highlights are put on a lot more dry. And we're going to just push and lift. You see those little feathers? Push, lift, push, lift, push, lift. And get lots of feathers. What you don't want is like a feather here, and a feather here, and a feather here. You want to overlap the feathers. Go and study the birds. It's so much fun to go to the zoo and study the birds. Now, sometimes I'm pressing down heavy with the brush. Sometimes it's a lighter pressure. And think layers, lots and lots of layers. And maybe a little bit coming off here. Sometimes, again, I use the side of the brush, the chiseled edge of the brush. And sometimes I use the flat of the brush. When I get up into little areas here, I use the chiseled edge. And then down here where the feathers are bigger, I use the flat of the brush because you want fatter, wider strokes, feathers. And just fade it down into nothing because this is just a study. But get pictures of the macaws sitting on branches with a whole bunch of neat foliage all around them, and paint the palm fronds and put them in a whole setting. Maybe we'll show just a little bit right here. I'm going to rinse my brush and pick up white. Get them in a whole tropical setting, and that's what's so much fun. Put hibiscus with them, or like we did in one, magnolias. Now this is just white. The highlights are drier, hardly any medium, or sometimes you don't need any medium. And this is just a little light bouncing on top of the shoulder area. And maybe up here on his head a little bit, the light would be catching a little bit more. Remember, the highlights go on last. And he's such a cute little guy. Wonder what I should name him. I sure wish I could have macaws, but my three cats would probably have him for dinner. So I don't think that would go too good. Although I know people that say they have macaws with cats. I don't know how they do it. To me, it'd be like living in a zoo. So you see how the feathers are just all nice and layered? Lots of layers. Get some more white out here. Maybe bring one out with the edge of the brush. Maybe another one down here. Now, if it gets too feathery looking, you don't want him to look like he stuffed his paw in a light socket. You can calm him down. I just, on the finished one that I'm working from, I just sort of indicated this area. I'm going to take a small little brush, and this black under his neck right here, I'm going to just use the side of the brush and just very lightly bring some of these feathers out. And see, I got my hand on here already. So if I were to go back and really finish this painting up, I would put a whole neat tropical background on him. And I'm going to go back, since I have a little bit of time. I'm going to take this little brush, and I'm going to reinstate this area right here, just a little. Some of these little pin feathers are darker, and some of them are lighter. You don't want all the same tone in here. You don't want just a whole bunch of hard black lines. But I take lots of painting photos of the parrots, and then I come home and I blow up just a certain section. Or I might blow up on my copy machine a copy close-up of just the face or just the beak area. So that way I can really see what I'm painting. You should always be very familiar with your subject that you're painting. Like a seascape painter does not go out and try to paint the ocean without knowing the ocean very, very well and knowing how the waves fall, how the waves crash. So you have to become very, very familiar with your subject. I'm going to put a little more shadow area right up here, just right, because sometimes the feathers, the forehead will come over and shadow this part of his face. And maybe just a little bit more highlight where the light might be catching on his beak. Let's take a look at the finished painting. The reference material. So now I'm going to take a reference material. So now I'm going to press the middle, leaving with no color up here. This is just the aqua and the white. Don't get too many feathers coming out. Now I'm going to take and rinse off my brush in the odorless thinner, and we'll get some white on the bottom. Anyway, I hope you all get to watch all our shows, because we did a really wide variety, even though Gary and I specialize in flower painting. We did a really wide variety of things on this show. I think you'll really enjoy it. We love to paint all different subjects. But flowers and birds are probably my favorite. Gary likes birds and fish. I'm just vignetting this out on the bottom. Vignette is where the subject, the main subject, just goes out into the background, and it's usually just all white or very light around the edges. And it just fades into nothing. Okay, I'm going to rinse off a brush here and go into white and light yellow. This is a very lemon yellow. And now the paint is put on dry. The highlights are put on a lot more dry. And we're going to just push and lift. You see those little feathers? Push, lift, push, lift, push, lift. And get lots of feathers. What you don't want is like a feather here, and a feather here, and a feather here. You want to overlap the feathers. Go and study the birds. It's so much fun to go to the zoo and study the birds. Now, sometimes I'm pressing down heavy with the brush. Sometimes it's a lighter pressure. And think layers, lots and lots of layers. And maybe a little bit coming off here. Sometimes, again, I use the side of the brush, the chiseled edge of the brush. And sometimes I use the flat of the brush. When I get up into little areas here, I use the chiseled edge. And then down here where the feathers are bigger, I use the flat of the brush. Because you want fatter, wider strokes, feathers. And just fade it down. Fade it down into nothing. Because this is just a study. But get pictures of the macaws sitting on branches with a whole bunch of neat foliage all around them. And paint the palm fronds and put them in a whole setting. Maybe we'll show just a little bit right here. I'm going to rinse my brush and pick up white. Get them in a whole tropical setting. And that's what's so much fun. Put hibiscus with them or like we did in one, magnolias. Now this is just white. The highlights are drier. Hardly any medium, or sometimes you don't need any medium. And this is just a little light bouncing on top of the shoulder area. And maybe up here on his head. A little bit, the light would be catching a little bit more. Remember, the highlights go on last. And he's such a cute little guy. Wonder what I should name him. I sure wish I could have macaws, but my three cats would probably have him for dinner. So I don't think that would go too good. Although I know people that say they have macaws with cats. I don't know how they do it. To me, it'd be like living in a zoo. So you see how the feathers are just all nice and layered? Lots of layers. Get some more white out here. Maybe bring one out with the edge of the brush. Maybe another one down here. Now, if it gets too feathery looking, you don't want him to look like he stuffed his paw in a light socket. You can calm him down. I just, on the finished one that I'm working from, I just sort of indicated this area. I'm going to take a small little brush and this black under his neck right here. I'm going to just use the side of the brush and just very lightly bring some of these feathers out. And see, I got my hand on here already. So if I were to go back and really finish this painting up, I would put a whole neat tropical background on him. And I'm going to go back, since I have a little bit of time. I'm going to take this little brush, leaving with no color up here. This is just the aqua and the white. Don't get too many feathers coming out. Now, I'm going to take and rinse off my brush in the odorless thinner. And we'll get some white on the bottom. Anyway, I hope you all get to watch all our shows because we did a really wide variety, even though Gary and I specialize in flower painting. We did a really wide variety of things on this show. I think you'll really enjoy it. We love to paint all different subjects, but flowers and birds are probably my favorite. Gary likes birds and fish. I'm just vignetting this out on the bottom. Vignette is where the subject, the main subject, just goes out into the background, and it's usually just all white or very light around the edges. And it just fades into nothing. Okay, I'm going to rinse off a brush here and go into white and light yellow. This is a very lemon yellow. And now the paint is put on dry. The highlights are put on a lot more dry. And we're going to just push and lift. You see those little feathers? Push, lift, push, lift, push, lift. And get lots of feathers. What you don't want is like a feather here, and a feather here, and a feather here. You want to overlap the feathers. Go and study the birds. It's so much fun to go to the zoo and study the birds. Now, sometimes I'm pressing down heavy with the brush. Sometimes it's a lighter pressure. And think layers, lots and lots of layers. And maybe a little bit coming off here. Sometimes, again, I use the side of the brush, the chiseled edge of the brush. And sometimes I use the flat of the brush. When I get up into little areas here, I use the chiseled edge. And then down here where the feathers are bigger, I use the flat of the brush because you want fatter, wider strokes, feathers. And just fade it down into nothing because this is just a study. But get pictures of the macaws sitting on branches with a whole bunch of neat foliage all around them, and paint the palm fronds and put them in a whole setting. Maybe we'll show just a little bit right here. I'm going to rinse my brush and pick up white. Get them in a whole tropical setting, and that's what's so much fun. Put hibiscus with them, or like we did in one, magnolias. Now this is just white. The highlights are drier, hardly any medium, or sometimes you don't need any medium. And this is just a little light bouncing on top of the shoulder area. And maybe up here on his head a little bit, the light would be catching a little bit more. Remember, the highlights go on last. And he's such a cute little guy. Wonder what.
I'm so quiet, I know. I had a lot of fun here. But in the feathers, I didn't think it was so fun. Oh.
I should name him. I sure wish I could have macaws, but my three cats would probably have him for dinner. So I don't think that would go too good. Although I know people that say they have macaws with cats. I don't know how they do it. To me, it'd be like living in a zoo. So you see how the feathers are just all nice and layered? Lots of layers, get some more white out here, maybe bring one out with the edge of the brush, maybe another one down here. Now, if it gets too feathery looking, you don't want him to look like he stuffed his paw in a light socket. You can calm him down. I just, on the finished one that I'm working from, I just sort of indicated this area. I'm gonna take a small little brush, and this black under his neck right here, I'm going to just use the side of the brush and just very lightly bring some of these feathers out. And see, I got my hand on here already. So if I were to go back and really finish this painting up, I would put a whole neat tropical background on it. And I'm going to go back, since I have a little bit of time, I'm going to take this little brush, and I'm going to reinstate this area right here just a little. Some of these little pin feathers are darker, and some of them are lighter. You don't want all the same tone in here. You don't want just a whole bunch of hard black lines. But I take lots of painting photos of the parrots, and then I come home and I blow up just a certain section, or I might blow up on my copy machine a copy, a close-up of just the face or just the beak area. So that way I can really see what I'm painting. You should always be very familiar with your subject that you're painting. Like a seascape painter does not go out and try to paint the ocean without knowing the ocean very, very well, and knowing how the waves fall, how the waves crash. So you have to become very, very familiar with your subject. I'm going to put a little more shadow area right up here, just right, because sometimes the feathers, the forehead will come over and shadow this part of his face. And maybe just a little bit more highlight where the light might be catching on his beak. Let's take a look at the finished painting that I have, that I'm working from. And I have a little more detail in that one. So, but you can see how I just brought the white up into it and then just brought the color down and just blended it right out. So I hope you go out and try these macaws. They're so much fun. And I hope you join us again, and Gary will be back next week. And so thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
I think it's done. I still don't know how to sign my animal painting. Because, I don't know, this is the first animal I'm painting, I've painted. I'm pretty satisfied with it. I can't say, I didn't like this or this, whatever. Because if you press and wipe up, gives you exactly the texture of feathers.
They say the eye is the entrance to the soul, and so we want to spend a little time on the eye to make sure we get that in. Because everybody that looks at a portrait of anything, they look at the eye first, and then they travel on. So it looks like it's going to be two bald guys up here doing their thing for you today. Let's look at the canvas up here. We have a canvas already started because, you know, I don't have a lot of time up here. I use a projector to project the image up on the canvas, trace it all.
I'd like to put something else, but I'm not sure.
And then this back here, this is a thing. I put that on.
Now I'm just putting some details.
Very important to take some of the acrylic and brush it into the head, so don't have a hard edge. The pattern will be in the book for you guys that are worrying about how to get that on. This color
brush is still perfect.
And this is wet. You can see it on my finger. So and this black, first of all, like I said, I started with acrylic, which is dry, and then I went into
just
black
gives
oil
you,
so that it is
three-dimensionality.
That's so that when I bring my feather work out, it'll hit that black
if you put
and sort of fade. Give me a nice soft edge. We don't want any hard edges
like
up
borders.
Here. That's ultramarine blue, a little shot over here.
I don't want to change the light. I just want to put
just
some more light on the
punch that up later.
I don't know what it's called that. But I think I'm just leaving it because it looks good.
We're gonna take a little touch of our ultramarine blue. A little touch of black. And what this is, this brush is a filbert brush. Rounded corners. And I'm using good old oil paint up here. A lot of times I forget to do you. I'm going to get a little more black in there. That looks like a little too much blue. And we want to get this nice dark in here.
Yeah.
Notice how
I the bottom.
To get these little edges coming in. We want to make sure we get that nice frown.
The border.
Gonna put a little dark here. There's a little dark, little teeny little separation up in there. And I'm gonna take a little more ultramarine now. Come up here. And I'm actually painting out into the background a little.
Didn't want to do
that. You can't see it because it's disappearing. It almost looks like the black and the dark I'm putting on are all the same value. So what I'm gonna do
maybe
is take a little aqua blue, and we're going to lighten it up just a little bit, not much, because that's in shadow, just to bring that edge out just a little. Okay, and then we're going to come in here and bring out just a little hint in there. Not too much, we don't want to scream and holler at people. Now, we're going to come up, because we have our nice dark
summer.
just kind of pull that down. Oh, another thing I've got to tell you, on the surface here, I have a little bit of linseed oil to help my strokes flow across. You can see how it's sort of drifting into nothing here. That's because there's linseed back here, but it's a very faint coat. Many times we borrow color, and we're going to put that down here because there is a little shadow that comes in here.
Yeah, I keep seeing more dimensional in this as well.
I already have the dark in here, which is acrylic, and around the outside edge, just a little bit. Coming around. Now, you notice the stroke is just kind of hit, because it's a lot of texture.
I don't like,
switch brushes. I'm going to come on down to the palette. We'll pick up our little round brush. We're going to take some good old white. The white that I use is titanium white. And why do I use titanium? Because the titanium has the best covering power of all the paint. So we want that in there. A little shadow. I'm going to take a little point. Now, here's a little trick. We're going to come in and pick up white by taking the brush straight in and straight out. What that does, it puts a little buildup of paint beyond the hair.
From far away, it's amazing.
It puts a wonderful little highlight. Maybe you get a little.
I think I just got a little bit.
You see? We don't want a big blotty.
Still don't know what colors I'm using to sign it. I just need to decide. So just in
plan. A lot of floral painting, so it's good to get away.
Yeah. I'm just leaving it for the moment. See you next time. Bye bye.